This conference will now be recorded.
Right. So, where are these classes? Why don't we see these classes? What we are doing? These are already there inbuilt in Python. Correct. So, this string is a class. You agree with me? List is a class.
Yeah.
And if you type print of type of 1, it will tell you integer. That is also a class.
Yeah.
If you type print of type of 2.5 float, this is also a class again. So I told you some days back, if suppose a is equal to 1, no, okay, a we can do instead of a, let's take some g is equal to 1. G dot, if you put and you press a tab, it will give you the methods relating to it, right? So these are the methods which are present within the class of an integer. Hello?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So if suppose G was 1.5.
So method in the sense, method and function both are same, or that is different and this is different?
Method and
functions. What the functions we were writing before, from day before yesterday class and yesterday's class, are okay. Method and the functions same, or they are different?
There is a bit of difference. I'll tell you what it is. Okay. So when you run this and g dot of this thing, it will give you different methods again. Okay.
Okay.
So for a string, different set. For a list, different set. For a dictionary, different set of methods, right?
Yeah.
So all this they have defined using classes. Okay. So how can you do that? Asal, what is a class?
Class.
You guys are aware about object-oriented programming?
I just know object collection of objects is called class. That's all. That is like from 10 years.
Okay. Yes, correct. Even I was thinking, what is this? Oops, I never knew before. Okay. Before I learned Python.
Classes have objects. This is the same answer again and again. We wrote in all the 4 semesters.
Okay. Anything that you know, Pawan?
No. I am from ECE, so I never took object oriented programming.
Okay. Fine. So first let's get into the theory, then we will come to this example, okay? Just for the sake of going to the theory.
Right. Yeah.
Good. I would say this website is very good, man. See, you Google anything from the basic level to the example level. If you want to prepare for any interview, you can come into this website, Geek for Geeks. If suppose you want to learn generators in Python before an interview, or you want to just go through an example, you can just come here. They will give you multiple examples. Along with that, they will give you explanation. And here this fellow is telling applications also, where you can apply it. So this is one very good website, Geeks for Geeks. Okay.
Generators, what is generator?
We will see it, Pawan. Actually, iterator and generator both are there. That is next level of class. You write a class and you just call a generator in one line.
Oh, okay, okay.
I will show you that later point in time. There is one class on that itself. I mean class. The session on itself. Yeah. Uh-huh. So yesterday I told you, right? There is if the class is something like a blueprint. Okay. Once you define it, you can replicate that to many things. Like suppose the best example I would say, we are I am like this today because my grandfather or great grandfathers were like this. They were looking like me, or they were talking like me, or something. It is all about the inheritance from their side. Correct? Agreed on this point.
Yes,
so
yes.
Similar way in Python also, instead of writing classes again, suppose today, instead of defining an integer, we are directly giving a is equal to 1, and Python is understanding 1 is a integer, correct?
Yeah.
How come it is happening? Because the classes are already written, and the classes are so fast or so advanced that the moment it sees 1, it will understand, okay, this is my baby, this is an integer, this is my baby, and it belongs to my class. Okay, or if you write 1.5, it will immediately understand, okay, this is a belonging to a float class, and this is mine. So the level of this classes are very good in Python. If you take the object oriented programming, inheritance, polymorphism, or such kind of things, the theory wise, I would say Python is most simplest to understand comparing to other programming languages. Okay, suppose to understand the need of creating a class, let's consider an example. Here, if you read out this paragraph, let's say you wanted to track the number of dogs which may have different attributes like breed, age. If a list is used, the first element could be dog's breed, while the second element could be representing its age. Okay, he wants to figure out among multiple dogs what are their breeds and what are their age. Let's suppose there are 100 different dogs. Then how could you know which element is supposed to be which? What if you wanted to add their properties to these dogs? This lacks organization. It's exact need for the classes. So did you understand their question over here in this paragraph?
Just on the need.
I get a sudden silence. That means it is a no.
I'm reading it actually.
Okay. Sorry. I'll scroll it back up.
It's okay.
You can explain now.
No. Anyways, I want you guys also to understand. Okay.
Last two lines, the half I did not get it. What if you want to add other properties to these dogs? So you want to add one more property, breed, age,
and how would you want to add to these dogs? Okay, so classes are basically to organize our data into particular formats to retrieve it and understand it better.
Correct. So the example here, he's telling he's having 100 dogs, correct? And he wants to store two variables, breed and age. Okay.
Yeah.
He wants to write that to a list here. Consider an example, let's say I wanted to track the number of dogs which may have different attributes like breed and age. If a list is used, the first element could be dog's breed, while the second element could be its age. So this fellow is telling first element in the list is breed, second element in the list is age. So he's telling 100 dogs are there. So 100 dogs, one list you will write. First one, Pomeranian is equal to, dog 1, Pomeranian, age 7, dog 2, Labrador, age 3. Dog 3 Alsatian, age 10. So if you write 100 lists, how difficult it is to organize, correct? How will you remember which dog is which one? Suppose you have 100 total dogs, you want to retrieve a Labrador. How will you remember it is a dog 2 or a dog 10? Correct? So handling with the simplest of the form, like a list or a dictionary, it is difficult. obviously. So in that cases, you know, there is something called as a basic blueprint wherein dog, under dog you have so many breeds, right?
Yeah.
So these breeds can go and sit under a class, obviously. One dog, how many features will it have? Can you name a dog's features? How can you distinguish a dog?
Color.
Okay, next.
Weight, size, age.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Breed.
Breed, the most important thing. Okay, right. So let's consider how many Pawan gave and Nagaraj gave. First, breed, color, age, size. Instead of size, you can go for weight. Size and weight, actually weight is a more referable term. So four variables you have, right? So you can define a dog class and you can inherit this dog class, and then you can write how many ever dogs you want to write. Suppose Pawan is having a Labrador, this guy Nagaraju is having a Alsatian, and I have a Pomeranian at my home. We will take the class of dog. And within that class, you will define your dog. Good, understandable. Okay, let's get into the programming. You will understand it better.
So basically, a class is like an high-level overview. So if you have dogs, cats, and some other animals, so we'll define those animals in a class, and then within the class, you'll have different breeds.
Okay, so you are going to point. So the point, if you want to define the class of an animal, okay, how many animals you have? Multiple, right? You have some millions of animals. So class of animal is first blueprint. Under animal, if you want to take only mammals, human, dogs, whichever have the vertebrate, right? So such kind of things. So those will go under, sit under mammals. Suppose you want to take the sea animal like fish, dolphin, shark, such kind of things. So you can classify. If you define a class of animals, under that all of us come in, right? Including the small, whatever, dog or something. So class is the major one, which is sitting on the top. Under class, you can have breed, you can have color, whatever attributes you want to define. So suppose if you want to just take class of human beings, okay, under that you will have most probably two, man, woman, right? Under man, you will have different attributes again. Under woman, you will have different attributes, right? Agreed on that point?
Yeah.
Okay, so defining a class would help us. See, as I told you sometime back, when you write a list here, when you write a list, list is equal to 1, 2, 3, and you put list dot of something, it is giving you, suppose L is equal to 1, 2, 3, you run it.
Print L, right? Print a type of L.
No, anyways, we know the answer. If you write L dot of something, where are these coming from? Pop, remove, reverse, sort, insert, index, extend, count, copy, clear, append. Where are these coming from? These are coming from the class of the list. Okay, this append is like a color. This clear is like a breed. This copy is like a weight. You guys are able to correlate?
So these are basically different attributes of that particular class.
Correct. So because we cannot call this as attributes, for a dog we can call attributes, but for this we can call these are objects.
Okay.
So this,
what
append,
does that object do?
This append is helping you to write one of the element to this list. So now when you call this list, it is giving you 1, 2, 3, 4, right?
Yeah.
So you have the class already defined and it is providing you other objects. These objects will in turn help you to handle the class. Simpler way?
Can you repeat it? Sorry.
This is a class. And this is a class, right?
Yep.
This append is an object.
Okay.
Agreed?
Agreed.
This append is helping you to handle a class in a better way.
True. Yeah.
So if you wouldn't have had this append, if I would have told you add one element to the list, how will you do it?
I have to write a while loop and then do check for each element and then check for the last element which you want to append and then add it.
Okay, again you are coming back to the point of append, right?
Yeah, that
I
would
told
be a
you
little
there is no append. I told
yeah.
you there is no append. Okay, so without okay. this object append, you couldn't have handled list, you couldn't have handled the adding of element itself, right? So whoever has coded Python, this fellow created two things. One is tuple, one is list. In list he gave append, in tuple he did not give append. Two different classes, right?
Yeah.
So he told tuple you use when you have a defined set. This is one class, defined, written. List is a class wherein you can append the elements, use it this way, correct? Two different
yeah.
classes, two different operations, making our lives easier. Get the point, right?
For list, we append. For
list
tuple,
only we have the append.
Yeah, but tuple, how to add?
We don't have any append. We cannot add elements,
tuple.
No?
Tuple is something that's fixed, right? We cannot add anything to your tuple. That's why there is no append.
Hmm.
Right, Abhishek?
Ah, yes. Actually, tuple is a defined set, Nagaraju. I would actually insist Nagaraju to read the sessions what we are going through. At least just go to this Geek for Geeks for when you are in office for 10 minutes and just read through the documentation.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, actually this website will work anywhere, man. You can just read through.
Okay.
So, okay, what is an object now? Okay, object is
okay.
an instance of a class. Instance of a class. A class is like a blueprint. This you guys remember now. While an instance is a copy of a class with actual values. It's not an idea anymore. It's actually a dog, like a dog of breed pug, who's 7 year old. You can have many dogs to create many different instances, but without the class as a guide, you would be lost, not knowing what information is required. Okay, we will dig into it. Okay, an object consists of state. It is represented by the attributes of an object. It reflects the property of an object. Behavior. It is represented by the methods of an object. It also reflects the response of an object within the other object. Identity. It gives a unique name to an object and enables one object to interact with the other objects. So let's get into the easier part of it. This, instead of reading the statement, if you read this blocks through, identity. Suppose we are considering the class of man. Identity. My name is Abhishek. Pawan's name is Pawan. And the other guy is Nagaraju. So we have a unique identity, right? Three of us. And state, I am currently living in Hyderabad. One is in California and other one is some other state. I'm not aware of it. So state and attributes. So color might be one is brown, one is fair, one is dark. So we might have different attributes here. And age, we might be some 30, 29, 28, something like this. Correct? So we have different attributes again. And okay, behavior might be we have different walking style, different sleeping patterns or some such kind of things, correct? So if you take this example of dog, so these three things are common, right? For any dog.
Yeah.
So can you have these three as the objects for a dog?
Yeah.
Agreed, Nagaraju?
Yeah.
Okay. Suppose you are having a class of a dog, boss.
Okay.
This one is common for everything because I told you this is the blueprint. Once you have the class of the dog, suppose you are having four dogs like this. One, two, three, four. Okay. once you have this blueprint, within this blueprint you are having these two things: state, attribute, behavior. You call this class and you define this dogs. Is it easier or not? Instead of defining every dog separately, you define the dogs within the class. Is it easier or not? Hello.
Actually, I didn't get the question.
Suppose you did not have a single class. Okay. The easiest example for you to relate is a list is there. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
You write. You are inheriting append, right?
Yeah.
From a list, you are taking append.
Yeah.
From a list, you are taking pop. Correct.
Okay.
Suppose you did not have something like list only.
So we wouldn't be knowing where should we pop something out.
Correct. Where you should append. You wouldn't have something called list. Then you had to handle with tuple only, right? You should have always had a fixed defined set. Then programming with Python would have been irrelevant for you. Is it right?
Yep.
So that is why these classes are useful. So when you define this class of dogs, you are having four dogs. These two are the common behaviors. When you see the example of what I'm speaking right now, you will understand it better. Let's go to the example itself. Okay. So class of dog, a simple class attribute is mammal. Under that, it is a dog. A simple method function. This is self. Self is a default thing that you have to write when you're defining class. Print of I am a self attribute. I'm a self attribute. We will run this program and we'll see what will happen. Okay. Let's take this program. I can directly show you the class of car, whichever is there in my notepad, IPython notebook, but I want to give you the textbook stuff. So that is what is happening right now. You might find it weird, but you will understand better. Okay. Here, class of dog, this is how it is defined.
Okay.
Syntax. Okay. You know how to define an attribute, right? A is equal to something, B is equal to something. This also you know, right?
Yeah.
Suppose you know how to write a function, right? You know how to write a function. Def of some function name. Within that, if you want to pass the variables A, B, or star args or whatever you want to do. But for a class, writing a self variable is important. I'll tell you why a self variable is important and how it is useful. Okay, I'll tell you that.
Okay.
For as of now, print this I am a is a hard code. Agreed?
Agreed.
These two are hard codes. This self dot attribute one, self dot attribute two.
You're using the
function. You will see. Right. But attribute one is here. Attribute two is here. Agreed?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
This function is not.
Suppose let's run this now. So if you run this, the class has run. Okay. The class got defined with two attributes. One is mammal, one is dog. And within that, there is some function called fun. So what attributes does this Roger dog is holding? Roger, you have defined that to a dog class. This is dog's name, Roger, or else you can take some Raju, because more familiar in India, we call Raju. Okay. Raju dot attributes.
My roommate name is Raj.
No, man, actually in India, it is most common thing. No? No, actually that is what it is. No.
Yeah.
What happened to this? This example's okay. Let's see, Roger, what happened to attribute? Did I do some mistake? Okay, dog attributes as no attribute. Attribute, what does it say? Stupid thing. Attribute one. Okay. So, Roger, attribute one is mammal, correct?
Yes.
Roger's attribute two is dog.
Dog.
Okay. When you call Roger dot fun. Okay, I'll instead of calling like that, I'll tell you it. Roger dot something dot tab. Now what you are getting?
All the objects that we have in that particular class.
Okay. So this Roger dot is giving you some three different things. Let's not name it attribute or method or something. So similar way, you are having L dot something and you do something, you are getting same some operation, right? So can you, are you able to correlate what is this L dot and what is this Roger dot?
Both are same.
Yeah, both are classes.
Both are classes and they are having some attributes or some functions. So suppose Roger dot fun, you are calling, run it. What answers it is giving and why it is giving?
It's running those both the print statements under the for defined function.
Okay, so it is telling, it is going Roger. We have assigned this to a dog class.
Yes.
Roger is assigned to dog class. Okay. Now you remember other day we had some functions, sum nums.
Yep.
Def of sum num like this, and then we had some operations, and we called sum nums, and if you had a star args here. I used to pass 1, 2, 3 or 1, 2, 3 to 100. Remember this, right?
Yes.
Both of you.
Yep.
So this function you had to call, you were calling for only one sum nums, right? Correct?
Yes.
But here, once we assigned Roger to dog, you are able to call Roger dot fun. Correct? Suppose you had Raju to dog. Okay. You can call Raju also to have these three variables, right?
Yes.
Okay. You can write Raju dot fun also. Okay. Suppose you had something puppy. Now puppy dot, you will have these three variables, right? Suppose, let me run. So this dog, three are different dogs, right?
Yes,
but they all belong to dog class, right?
Yep.
So this function is helping you tell that these all are dogs and these all are mammals. Agreed?
Agreed.
So you will have 100 dogs also. Can you just classify them into a dog using this simple statement?
So another doubt. So let's say we have a list of 100 dogs. Can those like defined within a single statement, all the dogs within a list can be classified to the dog class?
No, you are telling I will write something like this. Roger, Raju, Oppi is equal to some dog class. You want to say like this, no?
Yeah.
No, you cannot do it.
Okay.
But You might write a for loop or a while loop and do the assignment. That you can do.
Okay.
That you can do. That is just an assignment. No, this is variable. This is the function.
Yeah.
Write a for loop or a while loop. Just iterate through and assign it to dog. That is possible. Like this directly you cannot write.
Okay.
So Nagaraju, are you able to understand, Nagaraju, what is the use of this class?
Yeah, yeah. Inside the function, you can define how many methods you want. You can
correct.
Yeah, whenever you want to use outside the class. So,
if you write bark self print I bark loud, suppose let's run this. So now puppy dot, you will get bark also. When you are calling, put round brackets. Okay, how many ever classes you now? There is only one class. Write hundreds of functions. No, hundreds of functions, whatever you want to write. Just single statement, you assign it to dog. That's it. It will inherit everything. You got the point, right? Yes or no?
Slowly, slowly getting.
No, actually, see, I'll tell you. If suppose you did not write a dog class, boss. So,
okay.
How could puppy get this bark? Or how could puppy get this function of mammal and a dog? How could you get puppies this thing?
That would be difficult, right?
Correct. So to get a puppy's object or a variable or an attribute, you had to use this class of dog, right?
Yeah.
You had to create a blueprint for all the dogs. So once I create the blueprint, I can assign it to any dog. It's simpler, right?
Okay.
Yeah. So that's why we go for classes.
Okay,
so let's see some more examples. So Nagaraju, your question, object. This is object, Nagaraju.
Okay, inside water, then it's object.
Yes, correct. So suppose we are going for a class car. You are going for a class car. I told you yesterday, cars are like
class,
a blueprint.
Yeah,
within that Audi. You will have whatever brand, even the Tata Nano or the Audi. Okay. But both are a car, end of the day they both run.
Yeah.
Okay, so definition of init is, this is called an instantiation. This is called as instantiation. We will dig into further, we will dig into further why we do init, why we write self also. We will see those things going further. Suppose we are taking two variables. One is make, one is model.
Okay.
Okay. Make is equal to make, model is equal to model. This is the way you define the variables, as you did in the previous example also.
Okay.
This one, attribute is equal to mammal, attribute 2 is equal to dog. So suppose the class ends here. Assume only one function, one instantiation function. Now run this. Now if I don't pass BMW within this, what would have happened to my answer? Will I get an answer or no? What was the answer?
We need to give some variables, right?
Correct. Does it relate to something that we were learning yesterday and until yesterday? If you read this print error statement, can one of you read it loud?
In sing one required positional arguments make.
Okay. Forget about this class. Look at this function. Okay.
Okay.
Self is default. Never count self. Now you are having two variables. Correct?
Make
and,
okay.
Make and model. This is okay. Similar to what we have done def of sum nums. N1 is equal to something. N2 we hard coded to 4. You guys recall this?
Yes, yes.
So this is similar to this one now?
Yes.
Yeah.
So N1 we were varying, right? But N2 we yeah. always fixed it to 4.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, yep. what is missing now here? Which variable make. I have to pass?
Make.
So if I would have passed BMW, you wouldn't have got any error. Because one argument, I just defined the variable, but I did not pass the value. Variable was defined, value was not passed. But here, value, variable, everything is done. So it is not expecting me to give a model. So now, C1 off, you do a tab. Make, you will get BMW. C1 dot model, you will get the answer 550. Okay.
A small doubt. So okay. what is the function? Underscore underscore, that is the function name, right?
This is called as instantiation. I'll tell you further why we use instantiation function and why we use this self. What is the significance of these two? Okay, this you remember as of now, but I'll tell you why we use it. Okay,
because before we used to do it in a different way, right? C1 is equals to function name, and then we used to define the variable, right? Now we are doing C1 equal to class name and then defining the variable.
You mean to say this example?
Yeah, dog there example. Is a small yeah small difference between
this one and that one.
Yeah, they Sorry, here
I
we
are not I am not taking any object here.
Yeah,
I am trying to take an object here. This car, I am trying to take an object.
Okay.
This self will relate to this car instance only. I'll tell you, once we get into inheritance and polymorphism, you will understand better. So that's why I'm not skipping okay. the step. Because okay. if I tell you all those now, you will get even more confused. Okay. So if you want to define one more car, call this car of object you are passing, right? Benz, car of Benz 550i. So instead of passing this model, I would say BMW 550i. Suppose Benz, which class you want to take? Tell me for the sake of telling.
S class.
Okay. Suppose this guy Nagaraju is going in BMW. Pawan is going in Benz. Okay. Now I can give one more variable also. Owner. Okay.
So the 24 and 30 both are in one single program, huh?
So now see, this is very simple class, right? Only one car, one object you are defining. Within that, you are having only one function. This function is related to this car. Okay. And this car is having three variables, make, model, owner. Once you run this, it is expecting three variables now, make, model, owner. I'm passing three variables. Ayo, you got a spelling mistake. Sir Nagaraj, it is taking time. Okay, it took time for Nagaraju actually. Okay, agreed. So if you had to define like this with only one function, would you be able to do it? Until yesterday I told use functions so that your program should be able to be replicated, right? If you had to write L is equal to 1, 2, 3 and you had to do the operation of 1 plus 2 plus 3, I mean L of 0 plus L of 1 plus L of 2, I told you don't go that way, write a function, right? I told you until yesterday. Agreed? Do you guys remember? Correlate?
Yeah.
So, but today, if you write a class, you have only one function, you can use that class for how many ever operations that you want to do. Agreed?
Okay.
Yes or no? Yes or
if
no?
We have only one function, we can call that function in a class n number of times.
N number of times. See, I'm this guy Pawan, this guy Nagaraj. These two are independent people. They don't have any correlation. But I'm just taking the class of car. I'm assigning them to car class and I get the details of them, right? If you
so
have
can,
to maintain a, yeah.
Can we know in a reverse way? So if we know the class, like car is a class, right? Mm-hmm. Can we know if we put car dot dot and something like tab, we could know all the objects in that class. But
yes.
How can we know like how the each object is defined?
You want to write like this, Pawan? Something?
No, like car. Yeah, if not like that, like car dot, right? Tab. When we press tab, we would be knowing all the objects
correct.
In that particular class,
like,
right?
Like you know for list, correct?
Yeah. So, but what if I want to know like how that particular object is defined, like the definition of that object? If you go into the upper example. The above example.
Definition of the object, right? So
yeah.
For writing definitions, you have to use docstrings, right? Shift to tab. Once you write docstring, you can read through the definition of the object.
But we can't see.
No, there is no that is not there. But see, what is a class? What are the multiple variables? See, can you see the list right now? Can you see it right now here? When you see L dot. You press something, you know what all variables it is holding or what all methods it is holding.
Yeah.
And when you press L dot shift to tab, it will give you a doc string. What it is, you can
yeah.
read through.
Yeah.
There is a limitation for everything.
Okay.
So class also helps it. But classes are like our own created classes. See, whatever is there already in Python, let it be. But if you want to make the programming even more easier, write classes. You can stop with functions. I'm not denying the fact. But if you write a class, it is even more easier, right?
Yeah.
So let's jump into some things. We will correlate more. Don't worry. We will take a lot of time in classes to understand. So car object. Until here, you guys understood, right? The previous example only. This init method also you guys know now. Okay, I mean, just an example. This was also there previously. Now you are writing one more function. Make of the car, self.make, model of the car, self.model. You are calling a global variable, wheels is equal to 4. Correct? No
yep.
need to make this a local variable or a argument to be passed in, right? Wheels is always 4. Every car
yeah.
will have only 4 wheels. Okay. So what is happening here? T1 we are assigning to car, we are passing two variables because it is expecting BMW and model. Next one, Benz and E350. If you run it, your answers are like print of car dot wheels. This print is giving you the last answer of 4. This print is coming from here. This print is coming here. If you uncomment these two, You got all the answers right. Same example, but this is how to define a global variable. No need to pass this as an argument. Do you guys agree with me or no?
Okay.
So understanding what is a variable, what is not a variable also is important. See, car type, car make, car model, car owner, these are variables. These keep changing. But wheels, they don't change.
Yeah, it's different. Correct?
It is standard, four wheels only. So this example defines you that, like, which is a variable, which is not a variable.
Okay.
So when you write car dot wheels, it is always four because you are hard coding it. Okay.
Okay.
I don't want to go into inheritance. You seriously will not understand it. So let's just get into this stories. Okay, read through this self, man. What you understood, okay. We will break at that. Class, anyone wants to take the lead?
Yeah, class methods must have an extra first parameter in the method definition. We do not give a value for this parameter when we call the method. Python provides its. Oh, this is called self. Okay, yeah.
Self.
That's what you told. If we have a method which takes no arguments, then we still have one argument.
That is a self.
Here, you see, right?
Okay.
Now, 1 second, I'll show you. This one, self is default.
Yeah, yeah.
Make model or extra. You don't give any value for self. It is not expecting also. It will automatically assign.
So inside the class, when you write any function, you need to give a self.
Yeah. Correct.
This is similar to and reference in Java. Okay. Reference in Java. Okay. Okay, when we call a method of this object as my object dot method of arg1, arg2 is automatically converted by Python in my class dot method. Okay, my object arg. This is all the special self in object. Okay. Okay, in Java, as my object dot method, here my class dot method.
No, this is similar, but when you give arg1 to arg2,
here we need to
arg1, arg2. I'm not passing any self variable, correct? If you pass also, it will not take. It will take, why did you provide me an extra? This self is for Python only.
Okay, yeah.
It is not for us. Okay, but there is a use. If you write a self, this is very particular to this car object only. That we will know in the further examples. I'll show you that also. Okay, I'll just read through the init method, then we will call it for the day.
The init method is similar to the construction in C++ and Java. Constructions are used to initialize the object state like methods. A constructor also contains collection of statements, that is instructions, that are executed at a time of object creation. It is run as soon as an object of the class is inherited. The method is useful to do any initialization you want to do with your object.
Init method is similar to the constructor in C++ or Java. I don't know what is C++ Java. Constructors are used to initialize the object statement like methods. The constructor also needs a also contains collection of statements, that is instructions, that are executed at the time of object creation. It is run as soon as an object of a class is instantiated. The method is useful to do any initialization you want to do with your object. So some example they gave, class of person, init, self. These two are default, I told you. Okay.
Yeah.
Name, self.name is equal to name. This is one variable that we are defining. Sample method, say hi. Self, you are calling this self again. Okay, self is a default one. If you write self also here, it doesn't matter. If you don't write also, it doesn't matter. We will see. Hello, my name is self dot name. Call this variable here. if you pass P is equal to person of Nikhil, P dot say hi, the answer would be hello, my name is Nikhil. Confused, right? Both of you.
Yeah. To be honest.
I know. That's what I was telling you completely. Like once you get into classes, you will be confused more. But we will go through all the examples. No problem. We will make same classes also very simple.
Okay.
Are you guys not confident?
I probably after one or two classes we would be knowing.
No. See, until yesterday you were not knowing function, but you are writing a program today.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So you wrote a program also. Even Nagaraju also is understanding what is the thing with Python until yesterday. But today classes is a bit difficult. Everyone knows that OOPS programming is a bit difficult, but we will see a lot of examples so that you won't find it difficult only. Agreed?
Agreed.
Chalo. We will meet up tomorrow then. The time is up.
Okay.
But please revise until yesterday. Until functions you should understand to get into classes. I would say always that only. Please revise.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Chalo, then we'll meet up. Nagaraju, you will join tomorrow? Last Friday you did not join.
Last Friday, yeah. No, not me. Pawan did not join.
Yeah, I'll join
no,
tomorrow.
Last Thursday you did not join, no?
Oh. No, Wednesday I did not join. Friday.
Okay. Oh, so you guys will join tomorrow, no?
Yeah.
Actually, I have a flight tomorrow at 9 p.m. So can we do it a little bit early from? Oh.
Early means it is Nagaraju's problem.
Yeah, I cannot come.
Okay, so I have a flight till 9 to 11 actually. So it's not tomorrow though, it's day after tomorrow. I have a flight on Friday. Tomorrow for us is Thursday, right? I'll join tomorrow, but on Friday.
Yeah, Friday is fine. So at least weekly once we'll take off.
So, which day is holiday for you?
My all things are planned on Friday. I don't know why it's happening, but it's happening.
Tell me, man, tomorrow we are having or not?
Tomorrow we can have it. Yeah, tomorrow I'm available.